In Lesson 6, you will learn how to import your data files into Microsoft Access to build your database. To import your data into Microsoft Access, click on External Data. Next, under New Data Source, select the option From File, and then next, Text File, because remember, we modify the format of the file to TXT, Text File. Use the Browse button to navigate to where the files are located, and then select which file you wanted to bring into this database. I saved the files in my Downloads folder. Here they are. Before you import each individual file into a table shell, it's important to understand the convention name of your file. This file is for Rhode Island, so you see the abbreviation of the state. Next, you're going to look at a data segment. In this case, it's segment 1, segment 2, segment 3, for the year 2018. Let me show you why this is important. I'm going to click on Rhode Island segment 1 for 2018. Now that I have the file here, I need to make sure that I click on Append a copy of the records to the table, and I select segment 1 here, because this file is created for segment 1. Now we can click OK. Next, click on the radio button next to the limited in the Import Text Wizard, and then click Next. For your next step, click on the radio button next to Other, and this is how you're going to delimit the spaces in each field. We're going to type the pipe character. To type the pipe character, you have to hold down the Shift key and click on the backslash key. And now we can click Finish. When the import process is complete, you can click on the Close button. But you can also select Save, and you will save all the import steps up to this stage. This is not required, but it's definitely helpful. I won't be saving my steps right now because I want to demonstrate again how to import using Segment 2. So I'm just going to close. And at this time, you can go along with me by pausing this video for every step I guide you through. So open your shell for Microsoft Access, have your files downloaded and saved in the proper text format, and let's import into the shell. Click on External Data. Now go to New Data Source, From File, Text File. Use the Browse button to select the location where your files were saved. Select your file. In my case, I'll go with Segment 2. Click Open. On the Import Wizard, select Append a copy of the records to the table. And make sure to select the correct table. In this case, I'm using File 2, so I'm going to use Segment 2. Click OK. Next step in the Import Wizard is to click in the Limited. Click Next. We're going to choose the delimiter. In this case, will be Other, so click in Other, and add the pipe character. Again, you press Shift and then the backslash key on your keyboard. Click Next. And you're ready to import Segment 2. Click Close. I will repeat these steps to import the remaining data segments and the geoheader. Please remember that when working with large states like California or Texas, all four files cannot be loaded into a single Microsoft Access database due to a Microsoft Access file size limitation. And this limitation can be overcome by loading both the geoheader and one data segment into three separate databases, each one containing the geoheader and a single data segment. You have now completed the importing process of your data and created your own database to start working with the queries. Next, you learn how to extract the data, use the queries, and also export your data.